Hello everyone. This video will demonstrate the TI-ESC Spy-Slave, or ASIC mode, on DDR-less AMIC-110 with the C2000 EtherCAT slave. Traditional EtherCAT slave solutions are comprised of a dedicated and costly ASIC or FPGA, such as the Beckhoff ET1100, and use an external 8 or 16-bit MCU for control. AMIC-110 provides a high-performance, cost-competitive, DDR-less solution for both ET1100 register-compatible operation, such as a traditional implementation where the EtherCAT stack is hosted by a SPI-attached MCU, like the C2000, and a single-chip EtherCAT slave solution where the AMIC-110 implements the full EtherCAT slave and stack. In addition, the AMIC-110 software and firmware-based architecture and the PRU ICSS Industrial Communication Suite scales to support multiple industrial Ethernet and Fieldbus communication standards, such as Profinet, Profibus, and Ethernet IP. When combined with a C2000 MCU, the AMIC-110 provides a low-cost, high-performance, connected industrial drive solution. We will build and load two projects for this demonstration. The AMIC-110 will run the EtherCAT Slave Controller, or ESC, and the C2000 will run the EchoBack application, which also contains the EtherCAT slave stack. Now, let's proceed to the demonstration. First, we will set up the AMIC-110 and C2000 development platforms. Next, we will install the required software and tools. Then, we will generate EtherCAT slave stack sources and build the projects for AMIC-110 and C2000. After the applications are successfully built, we will flash the binaries to the C2000 and AMIC-110 boards and run the applications. Finally, we will verify the application functionality with the TwinCAT 3 EtherCAT master. Let's begin with the hardware setup. Connect the AMIC-110 ICE on top of the C2000 launchpad via the two 20-pin expansion connectors, as shown. Make note of the orientation in the picture to ensure you do not connect the boards incorrectly. Next, connect a mini USB cable from the C2000 launchpad to your PC. Then, connect the XDS200 JTAG debug probe to the JTAG connection on the AMIC-110, and connect an Ethernet cable to the J6 port. Connect the other ends of these cables to the host PC. Finally, connect a 5-volt power supply to the AMIC-110. Next, let's take a look at the software required to run the demonstration. Please note that the software version numbers will change over time. At the time of filming, the version numbers listed on the screen were used. It is recommended to install all of the TI software in its default location, C:\TI. Please note that if you choose to install in a custom directory, some modification of scripts will be required in later steps. If you have not already done so, please first install Code Composer Studio. Make sure that Satara AMX processors and TI XDS debug probe support boxes are checked during the installation. Next, install processor SDK RTOS for AM335X in the same directory as CCS. Please make sure to use version 5.0 or later of the processor SDK. Previous SDK versions require a patch to the SBL. More information can be found in the PRU ICSS EtherCAT User's Guide. Next, install the PRU ICSS EtherCAT slave software in the same directory as CCS. The final piece of TI software is Control Suite for C2000. Install it in the same directory as other TI software. After the TI software is installed, you will need to install version 5.11 of the EtherCAT slave stack code. Next, you need to install the TwinCAT 3 software. Please make sure to select the complete installation. Finally, you will need to install the Windows Patch Utility and a text file format converter in order to apply patches needed in later steps. Next, we will walk through the necessary steps to generate EtherCAT slave stack sources and build the projects for AMIC-110 and C2000. Navigate to the directory where you've installed version 5.11 of the slave stack code, and run the EtherCAT slave stack code tool.exe to install the SSC tool. Next, enter the control suite and navigate to the directory shown. Then, run the EtherCAT slave demo code executable to generate the SSC tool patches. This directory also contains the solution reference project, which will be used in later steps. Open the SSC tool and go to File, New Project. Then, click the Import button and choose c2xx_config.xml. Click the Custom button and choose the SPI sample application from the drop-down menu. Then click OK. Next, choose File, Save As, and save the project to a local directory. Then go to Project, Create New Slave Files, and click Start to create the slave stack code. After creating all of the EtherCAT slave stack sources, copy all of generated files under the source directory. Copy these files to the EtherCAT Solution Reference Project under the SPI EtherCAT Slave Stack directory. Next, we need to download a patch file from the URL shown. After the patch file is downloaded, navigate to the download directory and open up the escsetup.bat file. Inside this file, you will need to modify the environment variables to match your installation environment. For example, I will change the patch bin install path and the AM335X PDK install path to match my environment. After the environment variables are modified, save the file, and then run it to apply the patches and rebuild the PDK libraries. Now that we have the EtherCAT stack code, we can move on to generating the application. Before running the project create script, we must install the processor SDK products into CCS. To do this, simply open CCS and it should automatically discover the new products. If it does not, you can manually install them by going to Window, Preferences, Code Composer Studio, Products, and click the Rediscover button. Click Install to install your new products. After installation is complete, you will need to restart Code Composer Studio. After restarting, please close out of Code Composer Studio before proceeding to the next step. After closing out of CCS, open the projectcreate.bat file, which is located in the PRU-ICSS Protocols EtherCAT Slave Projects directory. After opening the file, edit the CCS install directory to point to your CCS installation, and edit the AM335X PDK install path to point to where you installed the processor SDK. If you chose to install products outside of the default C/TI location, you may need to modify other variables in this script. After modifying the script, cd to the PRU-ICSS Protocols EtherCAT Slave Projects directory. Then, enter the projectcreate.bat AMIC-11x ARM EtherCAT TI ESC SPI Slave command. This will create the EtherCAT TI ESC SPI Slave project in the same directory as the projectcreate.bat script. Now that the projects have been created, we need to import and build them in CCS. To do this, go to the Project, Import CCS Projects, and click the Browse button. Then, browse for the EtherCAT Solution Reference Project, which is located in the Control Suite directory. After locating the project, click the box next to it and click Finish to import. After the project is imported, right-click on it and go to Build Configurations, Set Active, and choose Option 5 for loading to the SPI Flash. Click the Build button to build the project. We will follow the same procedure to import the project for the AMIC 110. This project is located in the PRU-ICSS EtherCAT package. Import the EtherCAT TI ESC SPI Slave package to CCS. After the project is imported, right-click on it and go to Build Configurations. Then choose Set Active and choose the release configuration. You can now build the project. Now that we have built our applications, it's time to flash them to the boards and run. During normal operation, users are required to flash SBL to location 0 and app location 20,000. In DDRless mode, the SBL has to load additional binaries to PRU0 IRAM and PRU1 IRAM and store the TIESC EEPROM. The flash memory map pictured on the screen is set to flash the application binaries. The load location for binaries loaded by the bootloader is configured by providing the location in the TI image header appended to these binaries. The pre-built TI image binaries for EtherCAT frame handler and EtherCAT host interface can be found at PRU-ICSS, Protocols, EtherCAT Slave, Firmware, version 1.0. Binaries with and without the TI image header are provided. Binaries that contain the TI image header have an underscore TI suffix. An example pair is EtherCAT-FrameHandler.bin and EtherCAT-FrameHandler_TI.bin. Be sure to use the underscore TI versions of these binaries going forward. In order to load the applications, we must first create target configuration files for the C2000 and AMIC-110. To create a target configuration file, go to the File, New, Target Configuration File menu, and then click Finish to create a new target configuration file. For the C2000 configuration file, choose the XDS100 debug probe and the TMS320F28379D board or device. For the AMIC-110 file, choose the XDS200 debug probe and ICE_AMIC110 for the board or device. Then, save and test the connections for both target configuration files. Right-click on the C2000 target configuration file and choose Launch Selected Configuration. Once the configuration is launched, right-click on CPU1 and choose Connect Target. After the target is connected, go to the Run, Load, Load Program menu, and choose Browse Project. Browse for the out file completed during the build step. Once the file finishes loading, you can disconnect from the board. The EEPROM binary can be generated from an ESI file by using the SSC tool. To do this, go to the Tool, EEPROM Programmer menu, and then choose File, Open. You can find the ESI file in the Control Suite directory. Open the EchoBack demo application and choose the SPI version of the ESI file. Next, make sure to choose the SPI device from the Device Descriptions drop-down menu. Then, click File, Save As, and save the binary to a local directory. Make sure to choose Binary as the save type, and name the file TIESC_EEPROM. To configure the location of the EEPROM binary in device memory, you can use the TI image tool, which is provided at the directory shown. To use this tool, provide the device memory location and the binary you would like to append the TI image to. To configure TIESC EEPROM, type the command shown on the screen. Binaries are programmed to the SPI flash on the AMIC-110 by using the FlashWriter tool. To connect to the AMIC-110, right-click on its target configuration and choose Launch Selected Configuration. Once the configuration is launched, right-click on the A8 core and choose Connect Target. After the target has finished connecting, you can go to the Run, Load, Load Program menu, and click Browse. Browse for the SPI FlashWriter tool at the directory shown on the screen. Click OK to load the FlashWriter, and then click the Play button to start the FlashWriter tool. The FlashWriter program will print options to the CCS console window. Choose option 1 to flash an image to the board. You will be prompted to enter the full path to the image and provide a memory offset. The first image is the bootloader, which can be found at the directory shown on the screen. Next, enter 0 for the offset to start loading the image. After receiving a verify success message from the Flash Writer program, click the restart button in CCS to go on to loading the next binary. Then click the play button to reload the Flash Writer program. The next image to flash is the tiesc_eeprom_ti.bin file. It has an offset of 10,000. The next binary to flash is ecat-host-interface-ti.bin. Follow the same steps as before by restarting the program and hitting the play button. Then load from the directory shown and choose an offset of 14,000. Restart the program again and hit the play button. This time we'll be loading the ecat-frame-handler-ti.bin file. You can find this file at the directory shown. Choose an offset of 19,000 and load the file. Finally, we will reload the FlashWriter one more time. Then we will load the application file, or app, from the directory shown. This file has an offset of 20,000. After you have finished flashing all of the binaries, click the Terminate button to disconnect from the AMIC 110. Power cycle the C2000 board and wait for the LEDs to light up. Then, click the Reset button on the AMIC 110. The LEDs should light up as shown on the screen. Now that the applications are running, we can verify functionality by using the TwinCat 3 program. Before we can open TwinCat 3, we need to copy over the ESI file, which is located in the EchoBack Demo project folder. Copy the spy.xml file. Then navigate to the TwinCat 3 installation. Go to 3.1, config, IO, EtherCAT, and paste the file. After copying over the ESI file, open the TwinCat application and create a new TwinCat XAE project via the File, New, Project menu. Next, click TwinCat, Show Real-Time Ethernet Compatible Devices, and then ensure that your Ethernet adapter is installed. After confirming installation, go to the I/O tab, then click Devices. Right-click on Devices and choose Scan. After scanning for devices, click the checkbox next to the EtherCAT device, and then Yes to scan for boxes. Click Yes to activate Free Run. Next, double-click on the TI box. Then, go to the Online tab and confirm that the device is in the OP state. After confirming the state, you can go to the LEDs tab, choose an LED, and then go to the Online tab. Next, you can click the right button to change the LED state. We will change the state from 0 to 1. Next, go to the Switches tab and go to the corresponding switch for your LED. You should see that it also has a state of 1. You can do the same for other outputs. For example, data from master, click the right tab, and we will set the value to 12. Then, if we go to Inputs, Data to Master, we see that the input value has also been set to 12. This concludes our demonstration of TIESC Spy Slave on DDRless AMIC 110 with C2000 EtherCAT Slave. For more information, refer to the link shown. Thank you for taking the time to watch this demonstration. If you have any questions, please post them on the Texas Instruments E2E forum at e2e.ti.com.